Hold on, Farah, this is not a mosque. Does it look like a mosque?
Hello, hello.
Does it look like a mosque?
Have some respect in praying.
Does it look a mosque?
But it's not supposed to. That's the whole point.
But 21 mosques, what's the difference?
You don't have a house.
Why did you go there? No, I don't have a house.
You don't have a house.
Is it an issue?
Literally,
no, no.
If
it's
like a white person, they're not doing it.
No,
because
the thing is,
if
people stop praying, all of them Christians, and then that's the
Why are you harassing me? I'm not.
I shouldn't be playing that
shit.
Who do you think you are?
I don't know which one I should be.
According to
what is this?
Jasir Kadi said that there's holes in the Quranic narrative. Jasir Kadi said that there's holes in the Quranic narrative.
What is she saying, bro? What's that? Can I see she's saying this is the mouse for Anne?
What's that? Why do you have that?
There you are. Why did you leave Islam?
Hold on.
I left Islam because I got educated.
And the first question is regarding the urine of camels.
Oh, how backward.
So, Sheikh, you're telling me that drinking camel's urine is part of the deen? Akhi, don't get me wrong. Listen, and listen objectively.
I got educated.
There is a hadith in the Bukhari and others. So it is the highest of authenticity, no doubt about it.
That's embarrassing.
I didn't agree with the Quran being the revelation of God and Muhammad a perfect embodiment. In fact, I felt it was a questionable moral guidance.
Allah
is a false god, a false god, a false god. Allah is a false god, a false, false god. Allah is a false god, a false god, a false god. Allah is a false god, a false, false god. And Muhammad is not a prophet. Muhammad is not a prophet. If you want grace and mercy and love, Islam is not for you. But Jesus is the way, the truth, the way, the truth, and the life. Jesus is the King of Kings who died to save us all. If you just repent and believe he took your sins on the cross, then mercy and grace, forgiveness and love, eternity can be yours. But Allah is a false god, a false god, a false god. Allah is a false god, a false, false god.
What the hell is this? A'udhu billah.
Excuse me, Islam to me is one of the most, is the most feminist religion.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Qul huwa Allahu ahad, Allahus samad, lam yalid wa lam yulad wa lam yalid.
Show me your booty and what is it, panties.
A'udhu bi rabbil falaq min Allahus samad, lam yalid wa lam yulad.
Show me your booty and what is it, panties. You little boy, you boy, you little boy, you bastard!
Islam to me is one of the most, is the most feminist religion.
This is bullshit. It needs to stop. We are spreading apostasy. The only way that I can see to answer your question is change the hearts and minds of Muslim people. You know, we're seeing this rise of apostasy in Muslim countries, not just Western Muslims, but in Muslim countries. We're seeing the rise of apostasy to an extent that has never happened. It's got the Islamic scholars worried. Now they're giving sermons in mosques in Pakistan where they used to crap on Hindus and Jews. Now they're crapping on atheists. So, you know,
I believe we're
causing a huge dent on them. In 50 years' time, they're going to be like, yeah, maybe this is all from Muhammad's flying donkey and splitting a moon and camel urine. All that is bullshit. I keep saying it. This should be my next T-shirt should say, keep making Muslim babies. I will keep changing them into ex-Muslims. That is something that we're doing, and we're doing so far. The indicators are very good.
Yes, my friend, you are live on air.
Hello?
What do you like to say? Yes, you are with me. So you hear me now?
DCCI, how are you, man?
I'm very fine. You are a Muslim, my friend?
My name is Muhammad.
Yes, Muhammad. How I can help you, my friend?
Yeah, okay. Hey, listen. Alhamdulillah.
Stop you.
I'm sorry, I don't want to cause in your channel, you know.
Yeah.
I actually came here to debate you, to refute you, you know.
Yeah. But now you are saying the F word to Allah. And now you end saying the F word to Allah. How that how a human being can change 37 years of your life worshipping the false God who hate you for you are a black person. And now, after speaking to me for some time, you are saying the F word to Allah.
That's the first time I say something like this, man.
Yeah, but I understand. It's okay. I understand. Allah is the devil. I don't blame you. Allah is the devil. God, he did not create the black people to go to hell. That's not true. God don't take you to heaven or to hell because of your color. That's not true. Jesus said the
founder. It doesn't matter. I was born black. I didn't ask to be black.
It doesn't matter what your color, my friend. Who cares? The Lord, he said.
Exactly.
The Lord, he said, from their fruits you shall know them. He never said from their color. From their fruits. So if your fruit is good, you are good to the Lord. You are black, you are Asian, you are white, who care? If your fruit is ugly, he will recognize you by your fruit, not by your color. The Lord, he said, not everyone says to me, God, God will enter the kingdom of my Father, but the one who do his will. It doesn't matter if you're black or white or who cares. So this is obviously a very filthy cult. I hear you crying, my friend.
I'm hurt.
Well, I know it's hurt. I know. I understand.
I'm so hurt, man.
I don't blame you. Let your tears wash your eyes, my friend. You prayed for the wrong God for 37 years. Worshipping the God who hate you to death.
I'm sorry, Christian, I didn't
want to
go there, you know?
No, I respect you. Actually, you have a lot of respect from all of us. Real men is the one who cry when they see the truth, my friend. Don't worry about it.
I'm 37 years old. I'm a grown-up man. I'm married. I have two kids.
May the Lord bless your family, my friend. And now you see that the Lord, He blessed you. He blessed you with a beautiful family, so nothing wrong. Still, you can continue. And I invite you right now to accept the Lord, the Messiah.
Example, you don't understand, man. I forced my wife. You know, she's a wife woman. I forced her to be Muslim, man.
Well, you can fix that. No problem. You can fix.
She loved me. She.
Yeah, you can fix that,
agreed,
my friend.
You know?
You can fix that. You can tell her the truth. You can tell her that this is a garbage religion. We will not be there no more. That's it. She loves you. She will understand. And you can show her the reference and the reason. You force her, that means it's easy for her to leave because you force her.
My family didn't want to marry her. She has to change her religion, you know. That's why I'm hurt right now.
I understand. But never late, my friend. Never late. The Lord is still, He loves you. And the Lord, today as we speak, He made me stay longer so I can receive your call and make things work in the best direction for your life. The Lord is using me and using you so we can be together a light for the family, which is your family.
All right.
And I invite you, as we speak now, to accept the Lord, the Messiah, as your Lord, as your Savior. There's no name better than Him. Go and read what He said. Go and see His teaching. Go and see the wonderful things He did. He is the living Lord, even in the filthy Quran. The Messiah is right now, as we speak, is listening to us. He is up in heaven. Every man died, every man in the grave, every man became a dust, except Jesus. He is in heaven. Glory to His name. So I invite you, my friend Muhammad, to accept the Lord as your Lord, as your Savior, and so you can be saved and your family can be saved.
All right, please impress me, yo.
Do you accept the Lord as your Savior? Do you accept the Messiah?
If He doesn't discriminate me, yes.
I mean to that. Hallelujah, a happiness in the heaven of God for Muhammad.
If He doesn't discriminate me,
He won't discriminate you. How He would discriminate you? How He would discriminate you? You see, the person who discriminates you, He would not call you a child of God. Today, now, you are not a slave of anyone. It doesn't matter if you are black or free. You are a child of God. You see, you know what Jesus said, how to pray to the Father? He said, Father, our Father, we aren't slaves. Our God don't need slaves. He's God. He's glorious. Only sick ones need slaves. So our God, He said to us, when you pray to me, don't call me Master. Don't call me Lord. Call me our Father, art in heaven, because we are His children. So today, my Father is the King of Kings. He made me a prince, and He made you a prince, and your wife, she is a princess, and your children, they are children of God as we speak now, and there's a happiness in heaven for you.
Messiah, that's my Savior
today. I mean to that.
I'm rejecting Islam, man.
Praise the Lord for that.
And that's how you make a Muslim into an ex-Muslim.